He helped us to fund these.
Yeah.
These are feeder boxes.
Yeah.
So we build these. We're all volunteers.
Yeah.
We go out and attach them to the tree. What we want to do is keep the population of the red squirrel strong.
Yeah.
And that way they can withstand the greys moving in much better. We feel it's great that the community of Cushendall support the work that we do. And also this project of the big dish out is also totally fantastic. So we feel very lucky to have it.
I think it's great to show a local community deciding where the money is spent. And the Glens Red Squirrel Group are always dependent upon local support.
Big dish out!
That's a squirrel box here full of food just in case there's any damage done to any of the other ones. And what I have here is a bag of seeds and a wee scoop. And we would check these regularly and replace them if they need replaced. But this one, you know, it's still probably okay. It probably has a bit of life in it yet. So what I need to do is... You can see a squirrel has been at this, so there's husks in it where it's been eating the nuts, right? So if I blow out some of the old seeds, the husks from the old seeds that is, and just top it up with fresh seeds, and you know, that's her full. So we'll know the next time we come back, we'll know how active it has been and whether the squirrels have come back and have been eating some of the new stuff that's in it.
When I say big dish out, what immediately, what picture comes to your mind?
Well, the assistance that we got, the very useful assistance that we got for the project that we have to get seeds, boxes and some other equipment to better equip us to keep red squirrels in the area. Mm.
I think the thing about it was, I'd never seen a night where so many different people got together and heard about local projects. That's what I liked about it, the fact that normally we send grants away and a committee sits and decides. It was very democratic. The local public, whether they were young or old, got the chance to vote, and I thought that was what was great about it.
So it was a real good opportunity for people to come and actually see what we were doing, to see the boxes, for us to speak to them as individuals. Because a lot of them would see these boxes around the place and know that they're for squirrels without knowing what the actual situation is and what, you know, how many squirrels are left in the area. You know, how close are the grey squirrels to coming into the area. So it's a great opportunity to explore all those things and to hear people say things like, you know, I have a squirrel coming into my back garden. What can I do, you know? So then we would tell them how to keep that squirrel coming to the back garden and how to encourage the squirrel to come back. Well, you know, there was a bit of excitement obviously and a bit of competition because other people were looking for you know, had their own pitches in for their own projects, and they were all good, worthy projects, you know, and people had to decide on one or, you know, several over some others. So despite the fact that they were all good, worthy projects, we're glad that ours was one of the successful ones, you know. So it was kind of an endorsement too of what we do.
I'm the chair of the group, but Raymond did the pitching and he did a fantastic job. So it was real validation of not just on that night, but the work we've been doing all year, because when you are volunteers and everybody's busy with their own lives, it's wonderful just to see it, the achievement. And what was lovely on that night was that people took the time to talk.
Well, how many years ago did it start?
About 10 years ago. This is like a birthday bonus for us. You know, today we're doing that, just feeding them, but we need to keep them clean, keep them disease free. See, the grey squirrels get a thing called squirrel pox.
Yeah, it was a fantastic night. We really brought the community together. And, you know, everybody, all the local groups got to see what all the other local groups were doing. So that was a brilliant thing, you know, and it's a good opportunity to speak with other people and to see where there might be any overlaps between our group and their group. Mm-hmm. You know, for example, while I was there, I was speaking to the local men's shed, and they were then talking about how they might be able to assist us with some of the projects that we do, like, you know, possibly assisting with box building or other things like that, you know.
That's a good point, because since then we've actually made an arrangement with the men's shed that we're going to go there and the men involved there are going to help us in the work. So that's great. That's a very positive thing to come out of the big dish out. But even the fact that, you know, so often local people don't have a say in what happens in the local area. We've got our local politicians, but this was given the teenager of the area a chance to say something, the pensioners of the area a chance. I thought that was what was really special about
it. Yeah. It's a great model, and every council should follow it. I wasn't aware that every council didn't, you know, so I don't really know much more beyond our interaction with you, you know. So, but yeah, it's a great model, and it should be everywhere, and it's a great opportunity.